or something is about to come or something is within you. So this type of alarming is there. Now there are innumerable systems like Worldwide Wildlife Fund, then Wildlife Trust, then BirdLife International. So there are a lot of innumerable societies, research societies, which are doing some research in order to create cultivable or adaptable land structures. It is known as a landscape scale conservation technology, by which now they are trying to do all of these various things. Then there are final questions. Number one, which may come in all of these general common human minds, skeptic minds or normal minds. Number one, something is going to happen after several millions of years. Why to bother about now? Number two is something is happening in some part of the earth. What about India and why we have to bother about that? Number three, already government scientists and top ranked people, intellectual and potential people are working on that. Why we must be also included in this torture of either lectures or writing or mutual debates? Number three. Number four, what we can do? Yes, I am willing to do what we can do. Number five, yes, I can do something. I have already known I can get from sources. How much we can create impact in the society? How much we can bring some sort of a revital or revitalize this climate change issue to bring back the glory of the serenity and salubrity of the land again? How much we can contribute these things? And now, the final thing is, nature is born for depletion, disaster, deduction, decrease, disease, death. These things, all these are determined and destined. And how we can stop the nature? That is the sixth question. Seventh thing, we have been developing in the society. Most of the developments, even though you can say that it has resulted in climate change, we did not only receive the climate change, but also currency exchange. So how to stop these developments in the pretext of the development of the natural salubrity? So these things are the common questions that is in the society. And these questions have to be very exhaustively, elaboratedly, elucidated in various sessions. Still, whatever I want to say is, we have to make such a system which has more dependence on nature, which has more contribution towards the universal welfare or long-term welfare, and we have to either tune or reduce or abolish the systems that are upcoming. So alternative fuels are being invented, number one. Enhancers, power enhancers, like mediators between the tool and the user, they are used. Additives, they are also used for hyper efficiency. Number four, ultra developed technical mechanism is included, in which with less fuel and less emission, high efficiency rate in performance is being invented. Science should ponder more upon that. Coming to the conclusion, the real conclusion, philosophically, that which contributes to not only the inner but the outer climate change is negativity. We think that the society is spoiled only with the carbon dioxide. It is not so. There are innumerable greenhouse gases that are emitted by human beings in the form of disformity, informity, abnormity, disparity, cleavageal mentality, hostility, hatredness, envy, irreligiosity, immorality and various other things. That is the rule of the philosophy. And if somebody can understand the subtle mechanism of the climate change, they can understand not only the presence of carbon dioxide. For example, somebody told in the recent research that methane and also nitrous oxide is produced by human induction. 65% of the nitrous oxide as well as 37% of methane is produced, which is respectively 293 times as well as 23 times more than the impact of the global warming potential of carbon dioxide. 296 times more than the global warming potential of carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide is there. 37% of methane is induced into the atmosphere by human induction, which is 23 times harmful than the global warming potential of these things. So like there are alternatives for CO2 in the gaseous community, there are also alternatives and equivalence and hypervalence in polluting the society internally, collectively, socially or globally, which are all subtle factors, and they emerge from your mind. And philosophy says the more negativity that you develop, you are spoiling yourself. That negativity also impresses the society as well as the natural factors. The bounty of the nature must be replaced by your bounty in three things: gratitude towards the nature, proper use of the nature and proper distribution of the resources amidst the natural inhabitants. So there is no understanding, number one. We have only limited understanding our interim understanding, our immediate understanding, our peripheral understanding of the nature, then only we realize that, oh, we have done a mistake. And we are in a position, whenever we realize we have traveled a long way, so that we cannot go back. So, understanding the nature, exploring the nature without exploitation, and distribution of natural resources, this is the gratitude which we have to show towards nature. If you are not bounteous towards the nature's bounty will become a blow. Her care will become a curse. Her temper of embracing us will become a torrential tornado which will totally dismantle and disembellish the natural glory. So, philosophy, ethics, or morality, it says that you replace everything by love, proper distribution. So, this is the message of ethicism and philosophy, which we have to just conduct a different seminar on understanding the subtle pollutants of the society in the macro and micro level, starting from a mind, from a mass, that we have to do. And really, we are very happy. And this INVAG has been started just to create a process of dialogue, then interrelative meetings and discussions, and gradually penetrating into the society by small books. For small children and students, we must have illustrated books published. And I have already told from next month onwards, the previous meetings and their proceedings will be published and distributed in a very handy, precise as well as in a concise format. We have to do all of these things. I hope that this INVAG should take a march in various areas and various issues, and without just stopping within the stage or within an auditorium, it should reach the mass society, the broader and wider society in all regions, because most of the mass, those who are vulnerable, those who are those who are forming the potential quantitative mass of the society, they are uneducated, they are nescient, they are negligent and subservient to their senses and gratifications. Such people should be educated, and INVAG, I wish, bless, pray, and I also want to support that INVAG should take such a lead to create a drastic, the so-called desired change or development that everybody is anticipating in the society. Narayan, Narayan.